some big news coming in. The Rajasthan governor has finally given an appointment to the Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot, and the meeting will happen shortly. Here, Rajasthan governor reacting to Gehlot's statements, saying that the governor wasn't reacting, and now you have the Rajasthan governor coming forward to give an appointment to Chief Minister Gehlot to meet him. The meeting will happen shortly. Whether or not the governor is going to agree for a assembly session on Monday, whether or not the governor is going to agree for the rest of the MLAs to come to the governor's office to show strength, all of that remains to be seen. But as of now, the word is Rajasthan governor has accepted to meet with Chief Minister Gehlot. An appointment has been given. The meeting is due to take place shortly. Rajasthan governor. Rajasthan governor there meeting with Chief Minister Gehlot shortly. In fact, Gehlot just a little while ago addressed the media, spoke quite with some harsh words there, accusing the governor of being pressurized. In fact, claiming that the governor is being pressurized by the BJP, who's trying to arm twist several other agencies like the CB, the IT, the ED, to try and destabilize Gehlot's government. Despite having the numbers, the governor isn't giving him an appointment, is not willing to meet with them, is not allowing them to hold an assembly session. All these allegations coming forth by Ashok Gehlot just a little while ago. He seemed quite shaken after the Rajasthan High Court decided to stay the matter until Monday. A status quo to be maintained. Rajasthan High Court clearly said that the speaker can't act on its disqualification notice and disqualify Gehlot and his camp. A status quo has to be maintained until Monday. Remember, Supreme Court had also observed. Supreme Court is also supposed to be giving out its verdict on Monday. Supreme Court just yesterday had heard that Sachin Pilot and camp had raised a voice of dissent. Is it right to suppress voice of dissent? Is this the way that you go about in a democracy? This is what a point that was raised by the Supreme Court, and considering the developments in both courts have not been quite in favor of Ashok Gehlot and his government and his speaker, most importantly, it appears that they're quite keen on proving their majority on the floor of the House, or if not, even before the governor. And here, exactly the visuals that we're seeing, Ashok Gehlot and a bunch of them, MLAs there, headed towards the governor's office. They're meeting with the governor in just shortly. Moshmi joining us with details on that. Moshmi, are you trailing them? We hear that you're following Gehlot and camp. They're headed to the governor's office. Take us through how many of these MLAs are with him right now. Is this a show? Is this a parade that he's going to carry out in a moment from now to show his strength?
So as they say, the pictures speak louder than words. Here you can see that the Rajasthan in charge is seated right in front. All the MLAs right behind us in this bus. There are three buses that have left the Fairmont Hotel in this very picturesque landscape. You can see that these buses are heading for a political fight to Raj Bhavan. Clearly, Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot did say that despite the fact that I've not heard from the governor as far as calling the assembly session is concerned, or special assembly is concerned, I will be going to the Raj Bhavan. And here you can see that the entire bus apparently is packed. It's all jam-packed. And this is the last of the buses. India Today is getting you these exclusive pictures. You're right in the middle of this entire cavalcade that is moving towards Jaipur, towards Raj Bhavan. Let me tell you that this Fairmont Hotel is about 30 kilometers away from the heart of Jaipur city. So we'll see this cavalcade move around for a while now. I'll ask Ajay to also give you a picture of what's happening ahead of us. There are a couple of buses that are also stationed ahead. They're also going, a total of three buses, as Ashok Gehlot does claim that he has a number of 101 to 102 MLAs. So we can calculate about 30 MLAs to 35 MLAs in each car. And very interestingly, even as I look at these MLAs, there are smiles on their faces. They all look set and determined. Ajay, just give us a close-up shot of the MLAs, if we can see the faces and identify the MLAs, these exclusive pictures of the great political bus ride that Ashok Gehlot is taking of his camp to the governor, Kalraj Mishra. Things have come to a climax in the entire Jaipur potboiler. As you see, these images unfolding. India Today getting you the very latest here from Ground Zero. People talking on their phones. There are masks that people are wearing. And perhaps lots of questions were being raised as far as the social distancing, the corona protocols and norms is concerned. I would have jumped out of the car to get a quick reaction from these MLAs as we break at a red light, Nabila, but that's Marshall, not going to be possible right now. And here you can see waving at India Today.
You've got to take care of yourself waving, as well, Moshmi, but today, is it true?
We'll try and see.
Is it true, Moshmi, that a bunch of legislatures have come down with COVID-19? Is it true that a few legislatures are COVID-19 positive? Some reports suggesting that?
See Nabila, classic pictures, these, even as you know, this bus ride they're taking, the presence of COVID is all around. And even as they got a lot of flack over disregarding COVID norms, there were reports that a couple of legislatures were really down with COVID cases. And here you can see even as they head to Raj Bhavan, many legislatures are wearing a mask. They were waving at India Today. It is a very rocky ride that they are taking, because even as the road is smooth, the political journey for Ashok Gehlot is not going to be that smooth. We'll have to wait and see how that unfolds. But here, pretty determined, Ashok Gehlot claiming that he has a majority. He wants the assembly session called for, and with a silence from the governor, he takes the entire barrage and battery of MLAs right to the doorstep of the governor, saying that he should remember his constitutional duty. Nabila.
Moshmi, it seems like this is not the last mile, but nonetheless, even though Ashok Gehlot and team are headed towards the governor's office, this is definitely not the last ride. It's going to be quite a tough task for Ashok Gehlot to first of all convince the governor to have an assembly session at a time of a pandemic, but yet he's not sitting and looking at the situation lying down. He's got up on his feet, headed towards the governor's office. It appears that the governor has given him an appointment, but does the governor know that he's coming with the battalion, with all of the MLAs together? Does the governor know that this is a parade that is going to be carried out in just moments from now?
So Nabila, I'll also apologize to our viewers because there must be a lot of audio disturbance, but we can understand that these are all buses that are speeding at a very high pace. And here Pratap Kacharia was right there in that car, one of the very key MLAs. He was a Sachin Pilot loyalist, now a minister, and apparently Sachin Pilot had rallied for his make him a minister. He's sitting right there in the Innova, did wave to us. We are actually bound in this car, so we won't be able to get the viewers the reaction, but really getting you these pictures from Ground Zero, you can understand that each and every MLA would be mulling, and there would be multiple questions in his mind. You know, the heartbeats would be racing, because this is a time when they have the challenge to preserve their constituency, preserve their seat, and also a challenge to, in fact, save the government. And that's one reason that you see none of the MLAs, in fact, were very vocal today. We've seen many of them speaking out in the past few days. But yes, Ashok Gehlot making a political point there that he is not taking it lying down. He is launching a counter-offensive, batting on the front foot and attacking Ashok Gehlot. Had launched a barrage of attacks on Sachin Pilot, and today we saw that he took the central government head on. He did take Sachin Pilot head on, and now the governor raising a question mark on why the governor has chosen to stay silent on his request to call the assembly, even as the governor cited the...
Absolutely, Moshami, we hear reports suggesting that Ashok Gehlot now is taking his MLAs to the governor's office. If the governor does not budge and give them a date for when an assembly session can be held, we hear that the MLAs are going to sit in dharna right outside the Raj Bhavan. Is that true? Does the governor know that all of the MLAs are coming together to meet with him right during this pandemic? Because he's already raised concerns of coronavirus outbreak in the vicinity there.
That's right. And, you know, the fact is that the governor has raised concerns about the fact that if he called the assembly, one or two MLAs are already indisposed. Master Bhavarlal is indisposed. One MLA has been found COVID positive today. So is it a right time really to, in fact, call an assembly session is what the governor has said. But here you are. You can see that all these MLAs looking very curiously at the cameras, very keen to show their faces and, you know, trying to peep through that bus to ensure that they make their presence felt, give a message to their constituency. And this great political drama, the public of Rajasthan, if you look either sides, is watching very closely. They know what's happening. They're keeping silent. There are questions being raised about the ethics of politics here, but this is a political game of upmanship. And in a tussle, internal tussle of the Congress party, let me tell you, whoever really wins, the damage that it has done to the image of the Congress party is immense. The kind of the slugfest that we've seen, the political low that Rajasthan political landscape has reached, has really raised many questions.
Absolutely, Moshami.
Around Gayaram politics and about the democratic
undoubtedly
in the state.
In fact, Gehlot has said that this is not about the government's performance. This is about our deputy's over-ambition. Lashing out at Sachin Pilot, says Sachin Pilot was over-ambitious, which is what has crippled the Rajasthan government. But otherwise, performance-wise, they've been up there doing the duties. But clearly, it doesn't look like it. We're looking at a coronavirus situation, a pandemic that's consumed the globe, and Rajasthan is no different. Here, when cases have broken out even within the legislature's camp, there's a tearing and dying need to show majority, because it looks like Gehlot is sick and tired of holding his members at a resort anymore. He can't do it any longer. The MLAs in his camp are getting restless. They want to leave and go back to their constituencies, which have been left unattended. Remember, during a pandemic, all their constituencies have been left unattended. At a time like this, they've got to be there catering to their voters and their vote bank. And instead, they're huddling up just to save the government. And here is Rajasthan MLAs and the chief minister headed towards the governor's office out of sheer helplessness.
Absolutely, you know, this is an entire attempt is being made to save the government, and the public is raising many questions as far as the governance issues are concerned, even as the Congress has been alleging that it is the BJP that's not letting the government function. But the Ashok Gehlot government has been receiving a lot of flak. You have seen a sudden increase in corona positive cases in Rajasthan, even as it had done well initially, but to curtail the situation. But of late, the situation is not very bright. It looks grim. And on the other hand, you have a government, the opposition, the BJP at question, you have a government that is running from the hotel room. So you can see that these are the questions that Ashok Gehlot is battling with, apart from the fact that there's a huge challenge to prove his worth, not only to the public of Rajasthan, not only to his MLAs, but also to the Congress party, as far as the choice of him being made the chief minister's concern.
Absolutely.
It's about him undermining and underplaying the fact that Sachin Pilot did leave with the rebel MLAs and that there was not much damage done. So he has to really prove that Sachin Pilot was unable to damage his government, which looks a very, very tough challenge.
That's exactly the stand that Ashok Gehlot is taking. He's proving his merit, he's proving his strength, he's proving his majority, but even that is wafer thin. One above the magic number, 101 is the magic number, he has 102. With what real confidence is Ashok Gehlot? Of course, he's trying to hold back and hold on to whatever little that he has, but it appears that he's quite confident to show his majority right this minute. He wants to get done with it because most of his MLAs are feeling restless. But at a time like this, when the coronavirus pandemic is out there and as a dangerous situation of this sort, public health emergency that the country and the globe is facing, Rajasthan again is no different. At a time like this, the MLAs as well as the chief minister are headed to the governor's office, sitting there in Dharna. At least that's what they're suggesting. If the governor does not give them an appointment and a date for a assembly session to be held in the next week, maybe Monday, then they will go on an indefinite strike right outside the governor's office, is what sources are suggesting currently. But at a time like this, when a Gehlot and all of the MLAs within his own camp are divided, it all comes down to a big question. If BJP does not have the numbers, then call in for a presidential rule. Won't there be a word or a statement lifted by any one of those opposition members on a presidential rule? Currently, Rajasthan is looking at no governance at whatsoever. A pandemic situation calls for better governance. At a time like this, should there be presidential rule? Will that be a bone of contention now?
See, really, Nabila, Congress would want... I want that there is no governor's rule, the presidential rule imposed in Rajasthan. And they know that if they delay too much, Ashok Gehlot is really running out of options. And that's one reason that he thought that any more time wasted in the hotels, playing those antakshris and football games, was detrimental not only to his image, but the image of his government. It couldn't last for long. And here, running out of options, Ashok Gehlot threw that offer of a special session of the assembly being called, a floor test being done. He has claimed that he's got majority. But look at the dramatic visuals that are unfolding in Jaipur. The entire public watching as this great Indian drama, political drama unfolding in the heart of Rajasthan, the capital city of Jaipur. A marathon bus yatra is what Ashok Gehlot takes out. Here, people waving, looking at what's happening. Let me tell you, the people of Rajasthan are very, very politically aware. They would be knowing everything what's happening. And even as the cars have been stopped, traffic has been stopped, politics is in full swing as life comes to a standstill for a halt for a while as the VVIP cavalcade, the Netas, take out this dramatic political bus yatra, Nabila. The public would be watching. We'll have to wait and see. A dharna unfolding outside Raj Bhavan could make great optics for the Congress, but would it deliver results for the party is the big question, because they haven't got much relief from the High Court, or the Supreme Court would also be hearing the matter on Monday. And Ashok Gehlot seems to be not ready. Seems to be not. Chalo.
Ashok Gehlot, Moshmi, do take care.
Fact. Yeah, Nabila.
Moshmi, please be safe. Excellent coverage on that. Please do bring us those details. But we're going to quickly cut across to Dev Ankur there, who's right outside the High Court, to bring us details on that. Dev, this is an entire tamasha, if we could call this, of Rajasthan politics, where the MLAs, as well as the chief minister, 101 of them, all headed to the Raj Bhavan to meet with the governor, while the governor is hesitant to meet with them amid a pandemic. This is a situation where we're calling this a public health crisis. A situation like this calls for governance, but instead of actually catering to their respective constituencies and ensuring better governance and living up to their responsibility, here is the government of Rajasthan standing divided. On one hand, Sachin Pilot's camp. On one hand, Gehlot's camp. Gehlot there desperate to prove his numbers and get done with this and throw Sachin out of his government and out of the state Congress unit. And here, we believe that a dharna will take place in just moments from now if the governor does not commit to a date on an assembly session or a floor test, at least for Monday. That's the belief here. What do you know of the High Court there? We understand the High Court is going to be announcing a verdict on Monday. This has left Gehlot completely jittery, and that's why this move, do you believe?
Well, Nabila, the High Court has already given its decision. It has put a status quo on the Assembly Speaker's decision or the notices given by the Assembly Speaker. But right now, I'm not outside the High Court. I'm outside the Rajasthan Governor's House. And for our viewers' benefit, I would want to show as to how this entire Governor's House has been geared by police. There is heavy police presence outside the Governor's House, and no one is being allowed inside the Governor's House. In fact, several MLAs of the Rajasthan Congress have already reached outside the Governor House. You can see Divya Maderna, who is there outside the Governor House, and also there is Shanti Dhariwal, who has reached out here. And the police presence that is there, that clearly shows that the kind of tension, the kind of politically tense situation that is there. And clearly at this point in time, even as the MLAs are arriving, the Chief Minister is arriving outside the Governor House, the police is leaving no stone unturned to ensure that there is no ugly situation that arises out here. The Rajasthan Chief Minister, in a stern warning, has mentioned that the Governor should ensure that the assembly session is called for, and also mentioned that the government should not be blamed if people gherao the Governor House. It clearly is a veil threat from the Rajasthan Chief Minister's side.
Right.
And also, what you see outside is over here a tense political drama playing out in full public view.
Absolutely. Dev, a quick question. Does the Rajasthan governor know that all of the MLAs are coming by to meet him? Does the governor know that this is a parade that Gehlot is going to be carrying about in just moments from now? He knows that all of them are coming to meet him, or did he give an appointment to Gehlot alone?
Well, you know, that's a good question, Nabila. Right now, what we are given to understand is that the governor has not given time to the Rajasthan Chief Minister. After it was told that the Chief Minister can come at 12:30 p.m., but the entire, you know, entourage coming, that kind of a situation, the governor did not foresee, and the time for all the MLAs was not given. Although earlier we were told that the Chief Minister himself was given time for 12:30 p.m., but after the governor mentioned that the assembly session will not be held given the kind of corona pandemic situation that is there, how the situation pans out is something which, you know, is yet to be seen. But the Rajasthan Chief Minister himself has mentioned that he, along with all the MLAs, will be at the governor's house. He said that he wants to discuss the situation with the Rajasthan governor. He wants the assembly session to be called for. He wants the situation to be resolved. He wants the entire, you know, the floor test to happen, to the strength of the assembly to be seen, and his government to, you know, go beyond this entire the situation.
Well,
that has,
well, that's what Gehlot expects.
Political tussle between the Gehlot and the Pilot camps.
A clear message has come about from the governor that that won't happen considering the COVID-19 pandemic. Does that mean that all of the MLAs are now going to be sitting in dharna right outside the governor's house?
Well, there is a strong possibility of that happening, Nabila. As I mentioned, two MLAs have already arrived. One is a senior Congress MLA and Parliamentary Affairs Minister. He's also the former Home Minister of Rajasthan. He's Mr. Shanti Dhariwal. He's already arrived outside the Rajasthan Governor's House. And also, Divya Maderna is here. She's also a Congress MLA from Jodhpur. Both of them have arrived outside the Governor's House, but they are not being allowed to move inside right now. And you see a lot of police presence out here. If the camera person can show you, the entire street is filled with policemen right now. The entire Governor House has been besieged with these police personnel. No one is being allowed on the other side of the street, neither the media persons nor the common people. No one is being allowed on the other side. And at this point in time, you clearly see a politically tense situation emerging out of this entire impasse in Rajasthan.
Right, Dave, how far is Gehlot and his members?
Governor,
how far are they from the governor's house in the office?
Well, hardly 10 minutes away from here. We are given to understand that from the Fairmont Hotel, they have traveled a fair bit, about 25 to 30 minutes they have already traveled, and about 10 minutes is left. So you can expect the Rajasthan Chief Minister, his entourage of MLAs arriving out here within the next 10 minutes or so. And once they do that, how the situation pans out can be extremely interesting.
Right, are all of the MLAs there, Nabila, that are the MLAs all of the 102 MLAs there together? Is the flock together? Everyone's coming?
Well, absolutely. That is the reason why the Chief Minister wants to go in for a show of strength. He maintains that he has the majority. And even if the assembly session is not being called for, the Rajasthan Chief Minister wants to go in for a show of strength, and that is why he's bringing his entire flock of MLAs outside the Rajasthan Governor's house. Now, the doors of the Governor's house is closed. We are not being allowed to go near the Governor's house. We are on the other side of the street. This entire road, civil lines, where the Governor's house is located in Jaipur, is filled with policemen. There is heavy security out here. The media persons, everyone, no one is being allowed on the other side right now. And you see a politically tense situation panning out here. Senior police officers have already arrived on the ground. And even as the buses are on their way, they perhaps will be allowed till over here. But after that, what happens is something which, you know, is in the realm of speculation.
Absolutely.
Right now.
Still the confusion remains is whether the governor has given an official appointment or is Gehlot and his camp just headed towards the governor's office without a proper permission in place, without proper appointment. Has there been an official appointment given to Gehlot and camp?
Well, as far as the Chief Minister is concerned, Nabila, the appointment was given for 12:30 p.m. Gehlot did not arrive at that time. A message was conveyed from the Chief Minister's office that he was yet to leave the Fairmont Hotel on the outskirts of Jaipur, and therefore there will be some amount of delay as far as the meeting with the governor was concerned. But then the Chief Minister came out, spoke with the media, lashed out extremely hard at the governor and the BJP at the center, maintaining that the governor, despite being requested for time last night, has not given the time to the Rajasthan government for the assembly session to be held, and also mentioned that the governor was under pressure from the center, clearly hitting out at the BJP. He also stated, Nabila, that this kind of a situation is unprecedented as far as Rajasthan politics is concerned.
Right, absolutely. But what was the reason that Gehlot missed the 12:30 deadline there?
This kind of ugly low-level politics.
What is the reason that Gehlot missed the 12:30 deadline? Would you know? And is it also true that some of the legislators have tested positive of COVID-19?
Well, Nabila, as far as the 12:30 p.m. timeline was concerned, Gehlot came out of the Fairmont Hotel after holding lengthy deliberations today as well with the MLAs of the party, and perhaps that took way longer than it was expected.
So then whose fault is that?
And then he spoke with the media, so that took... Well, clearly, this was something which was conveyed to the governor by the Rajasthan Chief Minister that it will take some more time. But even now, even as the time has gone beyond 2 p.m., Gehlot is yet to arrive. So clearly, this is way beyond the scheduled time. And so now, this seems to be a show of strength from Ashok Gehlot's side, wanting to, you know, flex his muscle, say that we have the majority, we do not lack the majority in the Rajasthan Assembly, and if push comes to shove, we are willing to show our majority. Let us prove that.
The majority is proven? What really happens next? Suppose if the governor is also willing to see the parade and take check and stock of the fact that he has a majority, Gehlot has a majority of 102 MLAs, what happens next?
Well, constitutionally speaking, Nabila, the majority has to be proven on the floor of the house. It's not as if the governor, seeing the MLAs, will be satisfied. If the opposition says that they do not have the confidence, or a no confidence motion is brought, then the Chief Minister has to prove the majority on the floor of the house when the assembly is in motion. That is traditionally or conventionally what happens. Parading the MLAs before the governor is not going to be enough. If the BJP presses for a floor test, then the floor test will have to be done. Also, if the Rajasthan government on its own mentioned that there has been a lot of speculation around the dispensation, the Gehlot government, and that is why they're willing to hold a floor test and on its own call for a floor test and get that conducted. Now, if that happens, before that, a whip can be issued. And what happens to the rebel MLAs in that case is something which can be interesting, because if the rebel MLAs do not follow the whip, that can be a valid ground for Ashok Gehlot to convey to the speaker that these MLAs should be disqualified because they have failed to abide by the whip of the chief whip. Now, if the MLAs from the rebel MLA from the pilot group get disqualified, then that will bring the total strength of the assembly down by 19, which will help Ashok Gehlot ultimately, because the number of the majority mark will automatically go down from 101 to 91, and perhaps that will make the task of proving the majority for Ashok Gehlot all the more easier. So clearly, Gehlot is also indulging in political one-upmanship, indulging in semantics and symbolism.
Absolutely, what we see here is really not what is going to suffice. It's not a regular situation. We're talking in an eventuality of a pandemic. Considering a pandemic, even if he shows his strength, Gehlot shows his strength, proves his numbers before the governor right now, even then, will an assembly session be granted by Monday is a question here. Let's quickly toss to Chethi Narula, bringing her in on this. Here, we're looking at legislatures there. Chethi, Rajasthan politics turning ugly. The situation has now reached the governor's office right outside. They're going to be sitting in Dharna if at all the governor does not give an appointment for an assembly session. All of this in the midst of a pandemic, them ignoring their constituencies, leaving governance to the side, trying to save a government.
Affected as well. That's the news flashing across our viewers' screens at the moment as well. And the governor has maintained that the session, assembly session amidst COVID-19 is not ideal as well. However, Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot on his way to meet the governor, insisting on having that particular assembly session as well. And he's also, like you rightly mentioned, Nabila, threatening to sit on a dharna if the governor does not meet him. So we wait and watch to see whether the governor meets him or not. But the governor has a point. The governor says the assembly session cannot happen amidst the COVID crisis. On top of that, you've got the legislators who are infected as well. Some reactions come in, cutting straight across.
जनता का मैंडेट गहलोत सरकार के साथ है, और एक बात सुन लीजिए, ये कांग्रेस बीजेपी का झगड़ा भी नहीं बचा है कोर्टों में भी. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी है अध्यक्ष, विधानसभा अध्यक्ष और लोकसभा अध्यक्ष खुद कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी है. पूरा देश देख रहा था कोर्ट के फैसले को. न्याय चाहिए सबको. ऐसे चुनी हुई सरकारों को आप मनमानी करके गिराने लग गए तो देश की जनता माफ नहीं करेगी. लोकतंत्र का गला घोटा जा रहा है. राजस्थान के मुख्यमंत्री कौन है आज? अशोक गहलोत. राजस्थान की कैबिनेट किसके पास है? अशोक गहलोत के पास. 109 विधायक किसके पास? अशोक गहलोत के पास. अशोक गहलोत कैबिनेट कहती है विधानसभा का सत्र बुलाइए, तो राजभवन यहाँ गवर्नर हाउस से विधानसभा का सत्र बुलाने की परमिशन नहीं मिलती, मिलने की परमिशन नहीं मिलती. ऐसे होता है कभी? विधानसभा अध्यक्ष कहते हैं तो विधानसभा बुलाओ, सच्चाई सामने आ जाएगी. बीजेपी की पोल खुल गई है. बीजेपी के अध्यक्ष सतीश पूनिया कहते हैं कि हम आमंत्रण दे रहे हैं, तो इसका मतलब सचिन पायलट, बीजेपी सब एक हैं. और अब वो कह रहे हैं कि हम सरकार बना लेंगे. अब क्या लेने आ रहे हैं यहाँ पे? गांव में घुस नहीं पाएगी बीजेपी. राजस्थान की जनता ये तय कर ले, बीजेपी के लोग. इस तरह से बीजेपी की हालत हो गई कि जनता के वोट को छीन कर बीजेपी अपना भला करना चाहती है. बीजेपी
राष्ट्रपति शासन लगाना चाहती है केंद्र सरकार.
ये तो कुछ भी करना चाहते हैं, लेकिन ये तय कर ले इस देश में लोकतंत्र की हत्या करने का जो इन्होंने जिम्मा उठाया है, उससे राजस्थान की कांग्रेस की गहलोत सरकार डरती नहीं है. राजस्थान की जनता हमारे साथ है. लोकतंत्र का और संविधान का गला नहीं घोटने.
प्रताप सिंह घसी आवाज को भी आप सुन रहे थे इस तरीके से.
एक के कंधे भी डाल दो, टेबल टूट जाएगी.
All right, there you go. It's a big charge that is coming in from the Congress party, saying that the BJP is the one that is trying to topple the Rajasthan government as well. This is the crisis panning out in Rajasthan politically. We're getting you live visuals right there on your screens at the moment as well. Ashok Gehlot camp MLAs have left in buses for the Raj Bhavan. They are going to be meeting the governor shortly. We will see if the governor agrees to have that particular meeting and agrees to have the assembly session or not. If he does not agree, what they say is they will be protesting. They will be going on a dharna. For our viewers who have just tuned in, the Rajasthan High Court definitely has maintained status quo in the state until Monday for now, and the speaker cannot act against rebel MLAs till further directions that are coming in from the court. And there you go. those MLAs on your screens at the moment, you can see the Gehlot camp in those buses have reached the Raj Bhavan. They are going to be sitting on a dharna. Remember, if the governor does not agree to meet them, the Gehlot government has definitely put the Rajasthan governor under pressure at the moment. We will be joined by our reporters getting us all the very latest details as well, but that's the latest coming in there on your screens. They have reached the Raj Bhavan. They are insisting that the governor meet them. And for our viewers who have just tuned in, I was just telling you what has transpired. The Rajasthan High Court, remember, has maintained status quo in the state, and the speaker can now not act against the rebel MLAs till the further directions come in from the court. The High Court, of course, was expected to pass an order on the plea of the sacked Deputy Chief Minister Sachin Pilot and his 18 other Congress MLAs who are the dissenting ones, challenging this disqualification notice against them, but it asked for status quo to be maintained. And the Supreme Court, remember, last Thursday had also refused to accept the request of the Speaker CP Joshi to either stay the matter pending before the High Court or transfer it to the Apex Court. The Supreme Court, in fact, had observed that voice of dissent in democracy will not be shut down, and that's what they've been stressing on. And amidst this political crisis that you see, Gehlot has said that his government can provide majority on the floor of the House, and which is why also why he's insisting that the assembly session begin on Monday. But the governor has cited COVID as the reason why assembly session cannot happen. And on top of that, you've got news coming in that several legislators have also been infected of COVID-19. So not wise definitely to have this particular session. But Gehlot insisting, let me prove the majority on the floor of the House. Seems a little confident of having that particular majority, but we'll have our reporters join us with the final numbers as they stand as well. Moshami is joining us live from outside the Raj Bhavan. Moshami, at the moment, the Gehlot camp has reached Raj Bhavan. This is turning out to be a very big political circus from where we can see. The Chief Minister demanding the assembly session, all now eyes now on what the governor has to say on this amidst the COVID-19 crisis, of course, Moshami.
That's right. You know, this battle has really gone till the very last over, and Ashok Gehlot here, you can see that the buses moving inside the governor's house, and three buses full of all the MLAs of the Ashok Gehlot camp, waving, smiling, and trying to convey a message that all is well. Whether everything is really well, one will have to wait and see, but this is a point that has come to a climax, the political pot boiler here. And you can see that various MLAs trying to convey some message or the other. And here the media personnel is in fact circling the buses, trying to catch every signal, every message that they're trying to give. So all the three buses now inside, a barrage of media personnel right here outside the governor's house. We will have to wait and see what really unfolds inside. But let me tell you that this time round, Ashok Gehlot has really brought the entire battle to the doorstep of the Raj Bhavan. And clearly a message from the Congress government in Rajasthan, from the CM of Rajasthan, that they are going to fight tooth and nail, eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth, to ensure that by hook or by crook, somehow that they're
we know that the governor is not in favor of holding an assembly session in the middle of the COVID-19 crisis as well. But just to give us a sense of the numbers, in terms of the Gehlot camp, what do the numbers really look like? In terms of the Pilot camp, what do the numbers really look like at the moment?
See, clearly, if you look, that the BJP has about 72 MLAs in its kitty, and the Congress has about 88 plus 10 independents, and you have the BTP, which is 2. So if you calculate, it's about 100, and then you have one of the MLAs, Master Bhavarlal, who is indisposed. So somewhere the figure is hovering at around 98-99 for Ashok Gehlot, because you have to count out CP Joshi, who is the speaker in the assembly. He will only vote when it comes to a tie in the on the floor of the house. So two, Master Bhavarlal and CP Joshi, you take out. It's a very, very tight rope that Ashok Gehlot is walking, and he knows that. And that's why he thinks that much of it has got to do with your body language, has got to do with your political messaging. And if this is an all-out war, a full-blown attack by the BJP, as he alleges...
And just to put perspective in terms of the numbers that you're explaining, Moshami, as well, now that the status quo has been restored as well, the majority mark still stands at 101. And looking at the majority mark of 101, now put a perspective onto how the numbers look like and who seems to be on a winning wicket. Because also, the Bharatiya Janata Party seems to be on a clear wait-and-watch policy until the picture becomes clean. They don't... it doesn't look like they're going to be jumping in at the moment.
Jyoti, if you look what's happening here outside the governor's house, you know, if you think that you're in the midst of a pandemic and a COVID crisis where you need to have the social distancing norms in place, they've been thrown all out of gear here. An entire scores of police personnel right here, media personnel, the MLAs are getting down, deboarding the bus. It's a complete chaos here outside the governor's house. It, of course, will not do any good to the Ashok Gehlot government as far as, you know, tracking and tackling this crisis is concerned, as far as his message in the public. But let's talk about the numbers. As I said, that if you look at the numbers, the BJP has about 72. And if you join with the 72, the rebel MLAs, that are total 19 in number, that figure comes to 92-93. And you have the BJP that's got the support of the RLP as well. So the RLP is 3. That means 95. So one will have to see, and 3 more with the Sachin Pilot camp. So that gets the BJP number up to 98. And if you have a major strength of 200 minus 1, that is Master Bhavarlal Sharma, who will not be able to come to the house, then that's 199. And with CP Joshi out, a majority of 99 is what ideally Ashok Gehlot will be looking at, and his figures are just hovering on that borderline, and that's why there are anxious moments. Many can say that this is a step in anxiety. We will have to move out a bit to ensure that we are following the
basic
norms as far as this COVID crisis is concerned. But that's the situation. That's the situation right here on the ground, Chaiti. You can see that this is an entire political drama being played out. Scripts being written every day, new suspense stories.
But then, Moshami, explain to me, if the Ashok Gehlot camp, in terms of the numbers, are walking on eggshells, literally with the kind of numbers that you mentioned, what is the hurry to call for an assembly session in that case?
You know, Chaiti, everything depends on time, you know, and time is the biggest teller. That's the reason that Ashok Gehlot, who's a seasoned politician, he's been chief minister earlier as well, he knows that a thin majority is equal to having no majority at a time when many challenges are thrown at the government. And the Aya Gayaram politics is not new, and he knows that with his thin majority, without a test, floor test in the house, he is giving an opportunity to his political opponents to break his team. And that's one reason that after motivating his MLAs, showing them all the movies that he can of rebellion and of unity, lagan, you know, it's about team sportsman spirit, it's about team spirit, it's about challenging and rebellion, challenges and the rebellion space. So Ashok Gehlot has been doing a lot of brainstorming and psychological conditioning as far as his team is concerned, to ensure that they are psychologically strong to not get into be lured into temptations, as he would like to put it. But still, there are dark horses in the Ashok Gehlot camp. There are 4-5 MLAs who are very close to Sachin Pilot. They're still stayed at the Fairmont Hotel.
Right.
And his worry is that more time trickles in, the more relief that Sachin Pilot gets in the court, the tide might turn against him.
Right, we've got some breaking news coming in. Sources in the Gehlot camp have countered Governor Kalraj Mishra on citing COVID as reason for not summoning the session. That's the latest that is coming in. And Gehlot camp has claimed that no MLA is COVID positive at the moment. Congress MLA Wajib Ali casted a vote wearing a PPE kit on 19th of June in Jaipur for the Rajya Sabha polls. And MP Congress COVID positive MLA Kunal Chaudhary had voted in PPE in Rajya Sabha polls on 19th of June. Anand Patel joins us for more on this. Anand, Ashok Gehlot government doing everything it can in its capacity to ensure that the assembly session takes place despite the infected COVID reports that are coming in from that particular camp. Of course, they have them going and saying that no MLA at the moment is COVID positive.
That's right, Shetty. This is big breaking news coming in from the sources in the Gehlot camp. They are saying that the plea taken by the governor office for not summoning the assembly session despite Chief Minister requesting for a session on Monday, that the COVID situation doesn't allow a session. Here we have clear instances of MLAs who are COVID positive and they voted in the assembly during Rajya Sabha polls. At least two instances. You just read out the names. I'll just do that once again, Chaiti, for our viewers. Congress MLA Wajib Ali casted vote wearing a PPE kit. He was COVID positive in Jaipur during the Rajya Sabha polls on 19th of June. Second instance, MP Congress COVID positive MLA Kunal Chaudhary also casted his vote on the 19th of June in Madhya Pradesh Assembly wearing a PPE kit. He was also COVID positive. Two clear instances in which COVID positive MLAs were allowed to cast vote wearing a PPE kit. Now, Gehlot camp says there is no MLA at the moment in the Rajasthan Assembly who's a COVID positive. So even if there are, you have instances of MLAs who voted wearing a PPE kit, then what is the problem for the governor for not calling an assembly session, citing and taking the plea that COVID pandemic is there? So clearly the Gehlot camp going out all out against the governor. One, they're saying that the governor is acting under pressure.
If you had Congress positive MLAs going and voting for the Rajya Sabha polls wearing PPE kits as well, does not mean it has to be done again. It puts many other people at risk as well. Why unnecessarily expose yourself to a COVID positive patient? And what is the hurry in having this particular assembly session? The governor has a point right there, Anand.
Well, the other thing with the Gehlot camp is saying is that in the event of a flow test, if some MLA is COVID positive, his vote can be taken through a ballot vote. That possibility also exists, and the speaker can very well explore all these options. Why not summon the assembly at a time when there is a crisis? The government has come to a standstill. The chief minister is forced to keep his MLA locked up in a hotel because of the fear of horse trading, because his 19 MLAs have been kept hostage by the BJP in Manesar. So these are the points which the Gehlot camp is raising. They're saying that at the time of COVID pandemic, horse trading is being instigated by the BJP. And that is the reason why the chief minister wants to call assembly session to break this impasse, and he's not being allowed to do so.
Absolutely. And Governor, of course, has cited COVID as a reason. That's the breaking news that we're getting at the moment. Sources in the Gehlot camp have said that they've countered Governor Kalraj Mishra on citing COVID as a reason for not summoning this particular session, going on to show how in the past you had governors MLAs who had come wearing PPE kits in the Rajya Sabha polls, casting their vote as well. And the option given is at the moment to have a ballot vote in case he does not want the MLAs to show up in PPE kits. But having said that, they're saying that no MLA in the Gehlot camp is COVID positive, and that is a claim coming in from the Gehlot camp at the moment. We are getting you live visuals right now from the governor's house. Three buses with MLAs at the moment have reached the governor's house. This is a showdown that is taking place right there. They want the governor to hold an assembly session, failing which they are going to be sitting on a dharma. Dev Ankur is joining us from Jaipur for all the very latest on this. Dev, in the middle of all of this, how is the Sachin Pilot camp reacting, and what are the reactions you're picking up from the BJP camp as well?
Well, you know, right now, Chaiti, the Pilot camp is waiting and observing how this entire situation pans out, because it knows for a fact that whatever happens next, they can be having a major role to play, because after the Rajasthan High Court had already mentioned that there is a stay on the Rajasthan Assembly Speaker, and it cannot take any decision as far as the fate of the 19 rebel MLAs are concerned. The Gehlot camp is extremely keen to have the assembly session called for, and that is why it is parading its MLAs before the Rajasthan governor right now. And there have been three buses which have already gone inside the Rajasthan Assembly, the Rajasthan governor's home in Jaipur. And you see heavy security outside the governor's house right now. If the camera person can pan and show you this entire breadth of road in civil lines Jaipur, it is besieged by these police personnel. And pilot clearly knows that the situation that is panning out in Rajasthan can mean that he can play an active and important role out here, because Gehlot clearly wants at this point in time an assembly session to be called for and ensured that a floor test happens in Rajasthan Assembly so that he can prove his numbers. And if that happens, you know, if a whip is issued by the Rajasthan Assembly Chief Whip of Congress, Dr. Mahesh Joshi, then the pilot camp can be pressurized to come to the Rajasthan Assembly and be a part of it. If they do not abide by the whip, then that can be made a valid ground by the Congress to ask for their disqualification from the Rajasthan Assembly. And Cheti, that can bring down the numbers of the Rajasthan Assembly if the disqualification happens, and that will ultimately help Ashok Gehlot in proving his majority inside the Rajasthan Assembly. At this point in time, Governor Kalraj Mishra is in meeting with the Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot and with the party MLAs. Already about 100 MLAs have gone inside the Governor House at this point in time, and Governor Kalraj Mishra, after mentioning that that the assembly session cannot be called for because the COVID situation is playing out in Rajasthan, and that is why it will not be prudent to call for a Rajasthan Assembly session. But clearly it seems that despite that, Gehlot has been extremely keen, because he knows that he holds on to a wafer thin majority, and sooner the floor test is held, then that would be better for not just for his government, but also perhaps maybe for the stability in Rajasthan. Because
Gehlot will be afraid of certain defections that could take place, because clearly the pilot camp has now got more time, and as far as the Gehlot camp is concerned, as Dev was mentioning, they're on a wafer thin majority. Moshmi, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, Chetty. Yes, that's true. You know, we're talking about the numbers here, and Gehlot does really know that it's a very sticky wicket that he is on, and it's a very tightrope walk that he's doing, and that's one reason, the Congress quarters feel that the more time that Sachin Pilot camp really gets, the more time that the BJP really gets, will be actually very detrimental to the strength that Ashok Gehlot has. And that's one reason that you have Ashok Gehlot with his team right here at the governor's house. There were a lot of allegations and counter allegations that have flown thick and fast in the past 1 week to 10 days. Gehlot making very scathing attacks at Sachin Pilot. Sachin Pilot observing a very, very stoic silence. But, as they say, that he's let the bat do the talking, worked out the legal nitty-gritties. Sachin Pilot has got a relief from the High Court, and that's in fact a huge setback for the Gehlot government. And that's one reason, that one might think that why should Ashok Gehlot be really wary of what the High Court says? Because if he has the strength, if he has loyalists and his team intact, he shouldn't really worry. But the politics of today is about playing to the gallery, playing to each and every googly. The moment you're seen on the defensive, you'll have attacks and counterattacks on the other side. It is a lot of mind game. It's a lot of psychological warfare, you may call it. And that's one reason that Ashok Gehlot, who has tested the waters earlier also, he's been the man Friday for the Gandhi family, has been the chief troubleshooter many times, be it Gujarat or Karnataka. Really, he is facing the biggest test, litmus test of his life here, right in the heart of Rajasthan, in the capital city. This is a trial that Ashok Gehlot has to go through. It's not only a public trial, it is a trial in the courts, and it's also a trial of the faith that his team members really have, and the politics of Ashok Gehlot, as far as if you look at the dynamics and the rollout,
right,
as it comes out.
Moshami, stay with us. Dev, stay with us. Anand, stay with us. Remember, our battery of reporters getting us all the very latest as far as the Rajasthan political circus is concerned, and a lot is still to happen. This is the tip of the iceberg. This is a political circus. The chief minister demanding an assembly session in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic as well. Many updates coming in. Taking a very short commercial break. On the other side, continuing this complete coverage on Rajasthan Power Tussle.